Now today, listen up. Today was a very historic day for the ramp and for your life. This is the first time that the ramp has ever had a baptismal service like this, and you were part of making history today. Isn't that awesome? I'm gonna tell you, how many of you can declare that you will never, ever be the same again? Now, you're gonna go back home, and the people are gonna see the glow of the Lord all over you. They're gonna see that something significant has happened to your life. So I wanna set you up to prepare to share with them what God's done in your life this weekend. So I wanted to practice on your neighbor. Look at him and tell him this. Tell him, you should have been there. Now point to yourself and say, when I came through. Say this, the ramp was on fire. Throw your hands up and say in the Holy Ghost too. Put your hands on your head and say, from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. Come on, do a Holy Ghost spin and say, I felt the Spirit moving all over me. Come on, look at somebody else and tell them, you should have been there. Come on, when I came through. Come on, church was on fire. Now say, the ramp was on fire. And the Holy Ghost too. Put your hands on your head and say, from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. Come on, I felt the Spirit moving all over me. Now, how many of you ready to help me testify today? Here we go. One, two, one, two, ready. You should have been there when I came through. Church was on fire. The Holy Ghost too. From the top of my to the sole of my feet. Felt the Spirit moving all over me. Say,
you should have been there when I came through.
From the top of my head to the sole of my feet, I felt the Spirit moving all over me. Said, I got the rhythm.
A living one.
I got a rhythm.
A living one.
I got a
Well, praise God and God bless you, my friends. Welcome into the Gospel Music Jukebox Radio Program. Hey, going to be talking about a new project going on right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Praise God. So that's what today's program is going to be about. Project Love, my friends. Project Love. Write it down. Stick it on a sticky note. I mean, put it where you see it each and every day when you sit down to pray or read your word. Yep, Project Love. That's the new project going on right here at Sons of Thunder Ministry and the Gospel Music Jukebox. Praise God. Hey, we're going to be doing our Bible study tonight, Lord's willing, about 7 p.m. Central Time. So if you want to stop by, we'd appreciate it. And if you could, I'd like to ask you to share the programs with your friends, your family, your neighbors, your co-workers, well, with everybody you can. Help us get the word out that God's not dead. He's alive and lives forevermore. Amen. And he is working actively in the lives of his children. Praise God. Remember, throughout the program, we're going to be talking about, well, a new project going on right here. You got that right. Project Love. Hey, if you would, stretch your hands right toward the computer screen or the CD, radio, ever how you may be receiving this broadcast, and let's just simply go to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, once again, I would ask that you would hide us behind the cross of Calvary. Lord, that you would blot us out with the blood of thy only begotten Son. And Lord, as we open our mouth, we ask that your word continue to roll forth, for Lord, we know that your word will not return void. It will accomplish what you have set it forth to do. And Lord, help us to recognize your many blessings as you pour them out upon your people. We'll continue to give you the praise, the glory, and the honor for all things. It is in the precious name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that we do pray. Well, praise God. What an awesome day. Amen. It is a good day. It is a day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Well, praise God. Aren't you glad that God's love to us is not based on, well, how he feels about us? Think about it for a moment. Well, praise God. I said, aren't you glad that God's love to us is not based on how he feels about us? You got to know that love is more than an emotion. Listen, he may be, and I'm sure oftentimes is very displeased with us as individuals. Come on, you know what I'm talking about. Yet his love and goodness towards us are constant. Man, that encourages me. Because it means that God does not require me to have good feelings, because it's more than a feeling. We're talking about our relationship with Jesus, right? It's more than a feeling, but, you know, God doesn't require me to have good feelings toward everyone. And like you, I've discovered that there are people, well, I just don't like their ways. Some of the ways and things they do, I just don't like it. You know how we make friendships, you know, we begin to, you know, get involved with somebody and we make a decision. We either like them or we don't. We process what we like about them or what we don't like about them. But that's what we're going to be talking about right here throughout the program. New project going on because God's people are happy people. Hey, we're doing it. It's called the Project Love. For real, we'll be right back.
Somebody say amen. Somebody start ringing a bell.
Heaven knows there's a whole lot of trouble living down here below.
But we're smiling because when this whole life is over, we got someplace else to go.
People, happy people shine. believe.
Be a friend to the world. See how much love you can give.
Life is more than the air you're breathing, or spending more than you can afford. But happy are the people who always remember that happiness is the Lord. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
God's people are happy people, happy all of the time. Joy higher than the tallest steeple, love of the unstoppable kind. More than 10 million reasons flooding through my soul and my mind.
Guys, did you know you don't have to like someone to love them? Yeah. I mean, come on, look in Webster's dictionary. It defines like as, well, to feel an attraction, tenderness, or affection for someone. I mean, we say like, well, I like you because, you know, and whatever that may be. And we list the things we like about, you know, the person. Sometimes we remember things we don't like about the person. But according to Webster's Dictionary, you don't got to like someone to love them. But listen, got good news. But a gappy love says, I love you in spite of yourself. Yeah, I love you. You know, when we have the love that our Heavenly Father gives us, we're talking about I love you in spite of yourself, in spite of the things about you that I may not like. I can still love you with a gappy type of love, God love. Do you hear me? Hey, come on, write it on a piece of paper. You want to write this down now and tape it. I mean, like on your mirror, around your desk, or over your kitchen sink, or on your screensaver, wherever you will see it often. Write this down. You ready? Love is not a feeling. Love is an action. I said love is not a feeling. Love is an action. Amen. Praise God. You want to write that down, stick it up, and make sure you run into it throughout the day. Praise God. All right. Let's give a big shout out over here in the chat room to my daughter, Jessica Merle. She seems to be the only one in the house today. Hang in. Hold on. Others must be out on the battlefield doing something for Jesus. Amen. Praise God. She says, God bless all. I love you all. I'm listening and cleaning. Praise God. All right. the Lord is good. Amen. As we're talking about this new project right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Yeah. Project Love. And we're talking about how sometimes you may not like somebody's ways, but you can still love them with an agape love, a fatherly love that comes from our Heavenly Father. In spite of things you think, you know, that you just don't like what they do. I'm sure they were people, Jesus did not like their ways also. Come on, you read where he said to the religious hypocrites of his day, remember? He was pretty direct. I don't think he liked their ways very much at all, do you? He doesn't like sin, does he? And neither do we if we're born again, bathed in the blood. If we've accepted Jesus Christ as our personal Lord and Savior, we don't like foolishness and sin. We don't like nothing that would distract us from God. And sometimes people do things, and then all of a sudden we find ourselves not liking what they're doing, and then we begin to separate ourselves away from that person. But I'm here to tell you today, instead of separating, I want you to start praying. I said instead of separating, I want you to start praying. You know, but I know that God loved them because he died for them. You see, love is not a feeling. Love is an action, my friend. So this is our responsibility, to love others, whether we like their ways or not. Did you get that? I said love others, whether we like their ways or not. Huh? If you don't watch, what you begin to do is you begin to actually dislike the person instead of their ways. So today I want you to understand that we need to be sharing the agape type of love. It's love from God. Listen, if you've got a new heart, then you're a new creature. The old things are done away with. It's like pulling off the old coat, putting on the new coat. And, you know, the old man's dead and the new man rises with new thoughts. God give us a new heart, a heart of love and compassion. Amen. So I want you to ponder on that just for a minute. A lot of people does a lot of things that you may not like their ways. Because that's what we're talking about right here today on the Gospel Music Jukebox. New project called Project Love. Hey, let me give a big shout out to Savannah Ramey over there. Amen. Up around Garrett, Kentucky, up there in God's country. Amen. Where they have to pump the sunshine in, you know. Hey, we love you guys. We want you to know that. We love you guys up in that part of the country. We really do. Amen. Good to see Sandra Sloan in the house. Tell Brother Donnie we love him. And all there over round about Knott County, Kentucky. Amen. We love you guys. Today we're talking about a new project going on right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Project Love. You know, and we're talking about, you know, you've probably got people in your life that you just don't like their ways. And if we're not careful, that begins to separate us away from that individual. And before you know it, you just don't like the person. You know, it went from not liking their ways to not liking the person. I mean, come on, you've had to work with people on a job that you just dreaded to see coming. I mean, you know you're going to have to deal with them, talk with them. You didn't want to hear what they had to say. They spoke vulgar. Maybe they were drinking, and I don't know. But your list, you know, the list you make when you begin to become friends with somebody, and you're thinking about what you really like about that individual, and then all of a sudden you got a list of things you don't like about that individual. And some people are cruel and mean and talk plumb foolish, and all of a sudden we find ourselves not wanting to deal with that individual. But listen, there's a soul hanging in the balance, and we've got to push through. We've got to break through. We've got to really stand on the promise and the Word of God, knowing that He, if you're born again, that He that lives inside of you is greater than He that is in the world. And we've got to continue to hold on to the unchangeable hand of the great I Am. And we've got to press through the crowd, and we've got to respond with an agape type of love to those individuals individuals that we just flat out don't like their ways. We just don't like how they talk. We don't like what they're doing. We don't like what they wear. We're making our list now. You see what I'm saying to you this morning? Let me give a big shout out to Brother Chester Boston in the house over there around Dyer County, I believe it is. Hey, we're going to be up in that part of the country pretty soon. Before you know it, I think next week going to be like Tuesday or something. Anyway, I'm praying we're going to come up there pretty soon and get me a bowl of chili, Mama's chili. Anyway, thank you for stopping by and hanging out with us right here. Good to see my lovely wife in the house tonight, Pauline Chaney. Praise God. Today we're talking about a new project going on right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Talking about you, life that's give you, you know, trouble. I mean, you dreaded to see them come. You know, you was kind of like wanting to hide in the closet or something. And maybe sometimes you even hope, man, they don't see me. You know, and you be just trying to avoid a situation because you don't like the way they talk, the way they act, the way they dress. Maybe they talk too loud. Maybe they talk too soft. Maybe you just don't like the way they look. You know, maybe it's the appearance. I don't know. But every one of us have to face these types of situations. But now Paul said in his letter to the Romans that the Holy Ghost, who was given to us, has poured out the love of God within our hearts. Hey, you may want go over there and read Romans chapter 5, verse 5, and think about God's love for you. I mean, even John wrote to us, the greatest demonstration of God's love for us has been his sending his only son into the world to give his life through him. We see real love, not in the fact that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his only begotten son to make, personal atonement for our sins, my friend. And remember, God's love is without respect to person. He loves those people, well, that you just simply don't like their ways. He loves those people. Remember, whosoever believeth. So now we're beginning to see something that we're lacking in as the children of God. We're lacking in agape love, giving it. Yeah. What you receive freely, you're to give freely. And I know it's hard. I know it's hard, but you're more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. I know you can do it because God has equipped you to do it. Woo, praise God. Grab a hold of this morning. Man, there's life in the Word of God. We don't live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Let God's love pour all over you and fill you this morning. Remember how he loves you, even when you're not very lovable. Now, come on. You know you've been, at times in your life, not very lovable. Yeah, bitter, anger, jealousy. Man, just shut everybody out. Tell everybody to leave you alone. Now, come on. You know that's the truth. You see, that's the beginning of learning how to love other people, even the ones you don't like so much, is by remembering that God loves us even when we, at times, are unlovable. Because love is not just a feeling, it's not just an emotion, but it's an action. You see, if love is an action, then what action, you know, then are love actions in our life? Hey, I'll tell you what, run over there to 1 Corinthians chapter 13. It's a good place to look for a list of love actions. Yeah, I mean, come on, they include patience, kindness, not jealous, has good manners, unselfish, endurance. Just to mention a few, go over there and watch what happens. That's what we're talking about today. New project right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox, Project Love. And if love is an action, then what actions then are love actions? You see, patience, you got to think when we act with patience towards someone, you're loving him or her. Keep in mind that love is not a feeling, so we don't have to feel patient. Can you remember acting patient even when you did not feel patient? That is agape love, my friend. That's what we're talking about. Heavenly Father love that flows through you and I, the children of God, those of us that are born again, from breast to breast. You see, kindness, listen, when you feel like saying something sarcastic or, you know, cutting or anger, but instead you say something kind, that is a love action. I mean, you know, like, hey, you be on the job, they be walking up, boy, and they just be getting in your face, and you're trying to work, and they're trying to get your attention, and you just snap their head off, you know, I mean, you know, and you just say something sarcastic, you know, and bitter to them. Instead of doing that, you know, let's just say something kind. And watch what happens. That is a love action, kindness. When you refuse to behave proper, then your light definitely is flickering. I mean, people see in light, dark, light, dark. Well, we know that you can't serve God in the world, too. You can't try to fit into the world and then try to sell out to God. I mean, come on, you can't have it both ways. Sometimes just plain courtesy is a love action. I mean, think about it. You know, like when you're opening a door for an elder at a fast food restaurant or at Walmart, you know, you don't know that individual. You don't know them, so, you know, you don't have no list of like or don't like, but all of a sudden you do a love action by opening the door, showing courtesy. Yeah, and kindness. You open the door and offer to help them through, or sometimes maybe you'll offer to carry a bag for somebody or help them put stuff in their car. Maybe you see them trying to load something and they need help, and you just go over in an act of kindness, and that is a love action. And all of a sudden you're doing something that your light of is shining bright, and they're seeing and feeling that agape type of love that flows through the body of Christ, because it comes from our Heavenly Father. How often we forget good manners, right? Like not interrupting others when they're talking, you know, letting others go ahead of us, etc. Listen, when we do these things with kindness, those are love actions. When we let someone finish talking without interrupting them, and, you know, when we let others step in a line at the supermarket or at a flea market or wherever, at a fast food restaurant, wherever it may be, an act of kindness and preferring others before ourselves, and all of a sudden, you know, we find ourselves doing agape love. And love is an action. You got to know that agape love acts in an unselfish manner. You got to know this. Without pursuing selfish advantage or trampling over others and trying to get where you want to get. Remember, don't wait to feel unselfish. Show your love by acting unselfishly. You know what I'm saying? Do you get it? I believe you got it. We'll be right back. Be blessed. In Jesus' name.
That devil's got a beat on you, and man, it ain't no fun. There's nothing he won't try on you, 'cause you've got him on the run. When you have a little faith, show a little love, keep your eyes set on things above, and go to the Father when things get tough. Keep believing and don't give up. Thank you.
little faith. Show a little love.
Show a little love.
Keep your eyes set on things above. And go to the Father when things get tough. Keep believing and don't give up. Just go to the Father when things get tough. Keep
Well, praise God. We got to keep believing and don't give up. Amen. Hey, let's remember Brother Donnie Sloan throughout the day. I seen a post go by earlier where he must not be feeling too good. So please remember to pray for Brother Donnie Sloan. And also remember you can post your prayer request in the chat room. If I don't see them at the end of the program, I go back and I copy and paste those over. My little prayer book. So please remember, if you don't hear me mention it on the radio, that doesn't mean I didn't pray over it in agreement with you as we stand upon the Word of God and His promises. And, you know, and then I seen another one that slid by a while ago. Where'd it go? Let's see. Oh, Sister Sandra said she got reported for posting on Facebook that God exists. Wow. The person told them it was offensive. I told the person that I would pray for him because I didn't want His blood on my hands. Amen. Amen. I'm proud of you. And I know that people do. They try to use the least little things, you know, to just start some kind of controversy. And you done the right thing by praying for him. Not only because we don't want their blood on our hands, but you're showing this agape love that we're talking about this very morning. You see, endurance is one of the things we've got to remember. You see, when other people have given up and left, agape love will still be there. Hanging in with someone, it will, listen, love will endure all things. It will keep listening to someone even when you think you can't listen to another word. You know what I'm saying? You'll keep listening because of that love, that agape love that comes from our Father, flows through His children out into this lost and hurting world. Listen, these are just a few of the many love actions available to us. You got to know this. This is why we encourage you to get into the Word of God. Man, I mean, get in. Blessed is he that readeth. Get into the Word of God. Blessed is he that heareth. Blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of the prophecy of this book. Get into the Word of God, because man don't live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Get into the Word and ask God to write it upon the tablet of your heart. You see, there's just we're just talking about a few of many love actions available to us. And we can demonstrate these attitudes and actions toward people, whether we like them or not. We can, by God's grace. Listen, ask God to help you today to show you love through your actions, not your feelings, not your emotions, but to show you love through your actions. Even to the person you don't really like their ways, huh? You know, very much. But let's just ask God to help us as we let the love of God flow from breast to breast. You know, I got a saying I say, and this saying makes some people mad. I say, let's just love the hellish ways right out of them. Yeah, agape type love. Love can tolerate all things. Love covers a multitude of sin. Hey, love. If you ain't got love, you ain't got nothing. I may not like somebody's ways, but I better be able to demonstrate through action, not just word alone, not just talking about I love them, but love is an action word. It requires an action, love. Huh? It does. So now I've got to show them that I love them. How do I do that? Well, we're talking about some of that right there. You show courtesy. You show respect and honor. And I know sometimes, it takes a lot of prayer. But that's good. We need to keep praying. Because as we think about each of these people that we don't like their ways, I want you to think about them right now. think about some people that you know in your life, you just don't like their ways. You just don't like something they're doing, something they're saying. Maybe you don't like the clothes they wear. I don't know what it is, but begin to make you a list. Actually put the person's name there at the top of your paper, and then write out from it, you know, begin to write what you don't like about them. Because, you know, I want you to decide which love action would be appropriate for each one. I mean, you may have 5 people. You may have 10 people in your life or involved in your life that you just, there's things about them you don't like. It upsets you. You're worried about it. It concerns you. Or you just flat out don't like it. But you got to know how to love them. So here we go. You start with their name. Out from their name, you write down the things that you don't like about that individual. And then, as you see, each one's got a different need in their life. Each individual is in a different place and has a different thing about them that you just don't like. So now you got to figure out which ones require which patience, kindness. Does one require compassion or another endurance? Then set your will to act with those love actions toward those people. Do you get this? I know I'm gonna go slow right here. This is important. We're on a new project called Project Love right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. And I know, now listen, the truth will make you free. You can act all self-righteous if you want to and act like you just love everything about everybody, and that ain't nothing but a bunch of bull hockey. Because they people in your life that you don't like some things they do. Whether it be the way they talk, the way they use vulgar language, or the way they dress, or the way they talk and gossip, or the way they just give you a look that drives you crazy, huh? So I want you to write that name down. And then out from that name, you write down, you know, what it is that you don't like about that individual. And then you got to start praying and discerning, yeah, does one require compassion or another endurance, another patience, huh? Then set your will to act with those love actions. Remember, love is not just a feeling. Love is an action. And now that you've wrote down and you're looking at a individual that's involved in your life, you're looking at their name, you write out from it the things you don't like about them, and now you're beginning to see which love action you need to begin to pray for them and apply in your life with them. As you set your will to act with these love actions toward those people. Listen, it always helps right now at this point to remember that we're often unlikable to God. Yeah, yet he never stopped loving us. And it is the kind of love that should overflow from our lives to others, my friend. When that happens, when others can see that we can love people who are, well, not likable. Their ways is just not likable. A lot of people try to shun them, stay away from them, because, you know, maybe they get embarrassed. Maybe they just don't know how to deal with it. So hopefully with this new project today we're talking about, we're going to be encouraging you to do this over and over. It's called Project Love. So we will have one of the strongest witnesses of God's grace that we could ever have. You know, if you can learn to love people you don't like, it has to be a miracle right from God. And that miracle in your life can cause others to be thirsty for the eternal water that Jesus offers. So you think about it as you write that name down. The thing about that individual that you don't like. And then you pray and you seek some may need compassion. Others may need to use endurance. Others may need patience. Others may just need a shoulder to lean on. You see, Project Love is all about, let's start to find ways to reach out to those unlikable people with the love of Jesus Christ that is within you and I, my friends. Oh, what miracles would we see if we do this more and more. Project Love. You see, even when we were unlovable and lost in our sin, God loved us, that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believeth in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. This is what he's talking about when he's talking about turn the cheek when they smite thee on the one. You turn the other. We're talking about love is more than just an emotion. Love is an action. And we're calling the body of Christ, the army of the Lord, to action. We've got to start showing the agape type love to everyone in our lives. God put these people around you and in your lives for a reason and a purpose. It's not by accident that they showed up. It's not by accident that you call them or they call you or you text them and they text you. It's not by accident you're friends with them on Facebook or Twitter. It's all part of God's plan to put the right people in our lives at the right moment, whether we're the one helping them grow or they're helping us grow. But if you're born again, bathed in the blood, then you've got to be like that city that's set on a hill that cannot be hid. We're talking about Project Love right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox Radio program this morning. We'll be right back. But before we go, let me say, hey, God bless Sister Shirley Collins in the house tonight. Woo, well, today. She says, I'm listening, but on the road. Love you all. Amen. We love you too, sis. And tell Shiloh and the family, everybody there, tell your brother, awesome. We're just thanking God for those awesome praise reports. Also, Sister Sandra's shared about her experience on Facebook where she got reported. She's telling us he said he could prove God didn't create the universe. I told him I can prove God is creator of all. He got scared for some reason and reported me. Amen. Amen. We're proud of you, sis. Keep on keeping on. That's just giving the truth, sharing the love. Woo, praise God. All right, guys, we'll be back just in a moment, and we'll take right back off talking about this new project going on. Well, it's not new, but it is a project. Yeah, Project Love, right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox.
A bright and shining star, to me that's what you are. Dream come true when I found you. The half that makes me whole, and with all my heart and soul, a love that's true when I found you. Every day you make me proud. There's no way I can live without you now. You fulfill all my needs. To me, you're everything. That's what I knew when I found. As precious gold, with you I'll grow old. The search was through when I found you. A fairy tale it seems, a song of you and me. It's just us two. When I found you, and I can say every day you made me proud. There's no way I could live without you now. You fulfill all my needs. To me, you're everything. That's what I knew when I found you. That's what I knew when I found.
Well, praise God. Here's my suggestions today, friends, as we talked about Project Love. I want you to make a plan to love those people you don't like their ways. I want you to make a plan to love those people. I want you to list the people you find it difficult to like. Include what it is about them that, well, makes them unlikable to you. Then I want you to choose one unlikable person off of that list per week to focus on. This is the project, Project Love. You see, I want you to choose off of that list one of those unlikable persons per week to focus on. I want you to pray for that specific person each day of the week. Every day I want you to pray for them. I mean, really pray. Now, I'm not talking about just call their name. You're going to pray about this thing you don't like about them. You see, and then you specifically pray for that person each day of the week. You pray for the things you see in their lives that, well, that you think make them unlikable. Pray that God will help you to see and understand them the way He does, my friend. Pray God's love to overflow from you to that person in some specific way sometime during the week. I want you to call them. Maybe take them to lunch. Maybe just go by and visit. Just say hello and God bless. You see, if we will focus on one person per week and keep going through the list, what you'll discover is that God can even change your feelings toward them. But regardless, you will be showing love to those unlikable people. And the changes you will see in yourself will just astonish you, my friend. If you're really ready to grow, please apply these suggestions today. Start today. And begin to let the agape love of our Heavenly Father flow through you and in and out to a lost and hurting world. You see, when you start learning to love them, yeah, on your list there, they no longer have the ability to get to you like they used to, my friend. Oh, they may still have irritating habits and personalities, but they just will not bug you like before. It's amazing. It is amazing how that happens. You realize, wow, I'm free from that awful dread of seeing them coming or having to deal with them. Because even though I don't really like them, I really do love them the way Jesus does. So my friends, let us start to find ways to reach out to those unlikable people with the love of our precious Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. That's the project. We'll be sharing it over the next week or so with people. I hope you go back, listen to the archive. and take heed to the suggestion. Make a plan to love those people you don't like or you don't like their ways. List the people. Put their name down. And then put the reason you don't like what they're doing out from it. And then pray. And watch what God does. Let's remember, if you would, Brother Chester Boston, he's got to see a surgeon for his left eye. So let's remember to pray for him. Also, Sister Sandra says, need to have my brother Eldon Hammonds, his wife Rita Hammonds, and their daughter Kayla on the prayer list. I love them all so much. Oh, praise God. We will put them, we'll print that out, and it goes right in my little book. Amen. We're going to pray just in a moment. Also, Savannah says, please pray for my sister. I can't pronounce the word. I can't quite see it here. Lamikka. Okay, Jones and my papa. Amen. Also remember my dad. Yes, we will. We will do that. And please remember, we are still putting names on a prayer cloth that we have. So if you would like to have a name put on that prayer cloth, because we're going to be continuing to take that with us in revivals and have every believer to anoint and pray over it. So just simply tell me the name and say add to prayer cloth, and we'll get it put on there. This one's about full. We're going to be taking and putting names on another one. Praise God. But we're seeing and hearing results. God's not dead. He's alive. Man, it's just awesome how God has touched Brother Jody's sister there in Hazard, Kentucky. It's awesome how God has just reached down and touched Sister Shirley's brother there in Pikeville, there at the hospital at Pikeville. That's just awesome. God's moving. It's awesome to me when you just stand on the word and the promises of God. Amen. So, guys, please help us in this project, Project Love. We'd love to hear how God's working it out for you with the people that, well, they do some things you don't like. Maybe it's a loved one. Maybe it's somebody in your house. Maybe you're trying to hold on to God and everybody around you is living in sin. Write that down. Put that down and see how you can love the hellish ways right out of them. It don't always mean agree. What it means is to love them. Unconditionally love the agape type of love that only comes from our Heavenly Father. Sometimes love, you speak a truth. Sometimes you stand your ground. Sometimes you just love the hellish ways right out of them. Let's let God be God, because besides Him, there is none other, my friend. Amen. All right, give this a listen, and we'll be right back.
Got to tell somebody what he's done. I want to help somebody overcome. I need to let everybody see the power of his love. He said, speak to that mountain, and you just watch it be removed. There's no reason to doubt it. He'll do just what he said he'd do. 'Cause I know what he's done for me. No telling what he'll do for you. Oh, now Jesus is the answer. He's the only one for me. I said my Jesus knows the answer, the solution for the need. Oh, my Lord can work miracles if we just choose to believe. Thank you. I just trust in my Father.
I know He's watching over me.
Yes, He is.
Oh, now Jesus is the answer. He's the only one for me. I said my Jesus knows the answer, the solution for the need.
Oh, my Lord can work miracles if we just choose to believe. I said my Lord can work miracles if we just choose to believe.
Well, praise God. The Lord is good. And yes, Sister Sandra, we'll give you a call here after the program. Amen. Praise God. We love you guys. You're awesome, each and every one of you. I want to thank you for hanging out with me. We're going to be going probably for about another 30 minutes or so. Hey, guys, we're going to try to share some testimonies, some awesome music. And I'm going to be dropping a word or two along the way because... well, that's what we do right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox is uplift the name of Jesus. Amen. And you guys are just awesome. And I thank God that God has put prayer warriors around us and that take the time out of your day to stop by, pray with us, worship with us right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. I got another favor I want to ask you to do. I want to ask you to pray about doing this if you can. Yes. Call 1-931-229-0768. I'm going to give that number again. 1-931-229-0768. And share your pre-recorded testimony. It'll help us fill these airways with the good news, the glorious gospel of our precious Lord and Savior. Hey, you're an overcomer with the word of your testimony and the blood of the Lamb. You want to punch the devil upside the head? You can call this number 24 hours a day, anytime, day or night, around the clock. Call as many times as you'd like to. You can share a prayer request, a testimony. Maybe you just need to read a verse. But every time you do it, I'm telling you, when you resist the enemy and draw nigh unto God, woo, God will draw nigh unto you. Pick up the phone, dial 1-931-229-0768. I'm going to share that over there if I can in the chat room. You want to write it down, add it to your phone. It don't matter where you're at, don't matter when. But when the enemy starts hitting you, you want to overcome him, just dial that number. Share that testimony. Share that prayer request. Share that Bible question maybe you got. Or just shout howdy. We sure enough love to hear from you. And help us fill these airways with the glorious gospel of our Lord and Savior. Amen. You just simply dial 1-931-229-0768. You get 3 minutes, and you can call 100 times if you want to in a day. Whatever you feel led. But we ask you to pray about doing it at least once a day. If you can do it once a day, awesome. How awesome that is. But you be led of God and just simply obey God. That's what works the best. Amen. Praise God. All right, guys, give this a listen. We'll be right back.
Hello, this is Brother Boyd Blunden in Idaho. I'm calling in to shout howdy. I've got some prayer requests, and thanks for taking the time to pray for others. And prayer makes a huge difference. You know, we're told to pray without ceasing, 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18. That's part of doing the will of God. It says part of doing the will of God is praying without ceasing. And I can tell you, we've been praying for others, and we've seen people get healed. We've seen people overcome severe drug addiction problems and sin. And prayer is powerful, and prayer works. And you'll never forget to take the time to pray for others. God answers those prayers, and it changes people's lives. It heals them, gets the sin out of their life. It changes their eternal destiny. You can pray for people in your family, your relatives, to be able to find Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior, and it can help them. It can help them repent. It can help them to change. But I've got a few prayer requests here. I've been real busy the past couple days. I haven't been able to work the ministry stuff on Facebook, and today we got to get my mom down. She and started having some heart problems, and they got her down to the hospital and got her on some medicine, and people have been praying for her heart to actually do it a little better, but she's supposed to have a whole bunch of very detailed scans and different stuff done. They have to inject a bunch of stuff into her today and do scans on her heart and everything at the hospital, so we're busy doing that. Would you please just keep my mom, Jerry London, in prayer, and we love her a lot. Brother Bishop Eddie Cheney and Pauline Cheney have met her. She's just a great lady, and just we're claiming the total healing of her heart in the name of Jesus. So thank you for keeping her in prayer today as she has all those scans and the different things done at the hospital, and we're claiming her total healing. And also, we're working on those visas, trying to get Edna and Isabel over here from the Philippines. My fiance Edna, I've known her for 6 years. They have an interview at the U.S. Embassy at Manila on April 14th at 9:45 in the morning. They live in the southern part of the Philippines. They have to travel clear up to Manila, and they have to go in for a big interview at the U.S. Embassy at Manila in the Philippines at 9:45 in the morning on April 14th. And be praying for God to help us with those visas. And we tried some other visas about a year ago. They got denied, so we're trying some different visas. And be praying for us, because if I can get Edna and Isabel over here, they'll be part of the ministry that I'm involved in. They'll be calling into this testimony line. They'll be in the chat room on the programs. They'll be helping me take care of the disabled people we take care of here, and it'll be a real blessing to have them over here. So just thank you so much for the prayers for us, and also for me, I'm claiming total healing of those food allergy problems. I've been getting better also. God's been healing me, and please be praying for me to be totally healed also, and we just thank God. God is good, and Jesus is good. And remember, don't forget to take the time to pray for others. Those prayers get answered, and people get healed. And have a good day, and God bless you, and we'll be praying for you all. Amen.
I don't see the man in my mirror. I'm just not myself these days. There's a change in me. Each mistake I've made no longer haunts my memory. They're just all that's left of the man I used to be. Oh, and each step I take's not alone. There's someone with me. You know he's placed my rock, which I will stand.
God. We owe it all to Jesus. Hey, guys, I'd ask you to remember to pray for me and my wife, Pauline. She's getting a little bit of that belly virus, I believe. Her stomach's bothering her quite a bit this morning. She had to go lay back down. And I was up all night with an old bad headache, trying to clean and work on these computers. And, you know, the old devil's mad. But that's okay. He's going to stay mad until he gets cast into the lake of fire. He's mad. That's okay, because we know he that lives in us, those of us that are born again, bathed in the blood. He that lives in us is greater than he that is in the world. But please, if you would, take time throughout the day and when you pray to mention old Bishop Eddie Chaney and my wife, Pauline Chaney, and remember Sons of Thunder Ministry, amen, and the Gospel Music Jukebox. Pray that we can get up and get out more, that we'll gain new listeners and people that'll help and get involved by sharing the program, calling the testimony lines, leaving awesome comments like you guys do. You set good examples, each and every one of you. Amen. So I want to say thank you to the prayer warriors that are able to show up as much as you guys do. Some of you are pretty regular, and I appreciate that. I really do, because I know it's time-consuming. But I know that when I can't be on the highways and byways compelling people to come in, this is the avenue we use, yes, it is, to get the gospel out to a lost and hurting world, my friend. This is just a tool to be used to spread the glorious gospel of our precious Lord and Savior. So help us. You can dial 1-931-229-0768. Share your pre-recorded testimony, Bible question. Hey, challenge them on a Bible question. Throw one out there. Put it on there. We'll play it. Give people some homework. Amen. Praise God. Hey, that reminds me. Tonight, Lord willing, at 7 p.m. Central Time, if you can, come on by. We're going to be trying to finish up the Bible study that we started last night when the computer started going all crazy. We're going to be right back on there, get that finished up, Lord's willing, and get that out and about and over in the archive as one program so we can delete the two parts that's up there now, because it messed up. It lost a lot of information I want to share with you. Amen. So be praying for us, and we're going to be doing the same for each one of you. We're going to hang out about another half hour here. We're going to be sharing testimonies and uplifting Jesus through song and word. Just know that God loves you right there, right now, whatever you're going through. You don't have to go through it alone. Cast your cares upon Jesus, for he cares for you, my friend. If you're listening to the broadcast and you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, well, I want to share some good news with you. Today is the day of salvation. Right now, this very moment, you too can become a new creature in Christ Jesus. If you'll run to him with that broken heart and a contrite spirit, listen, if you're ready to turn from the wickedness of the world, if you're ready to repent and walk away from sin, if you're ready to say, I'm tired of being tired, if you're ready to deny yourself, pick up your cross and follow after Jesus, listen, he'll no wise cast you out, my friend, if you'll come to him with that broken heart and a contrite spirit. If you really, really mean it, you're really ready to let go and let God have his way. Just simply repent and fall in love with Jesus. We love you. We're praying with you and for you. But this is one decision that you got to make yourself, my friend. You must choose this day whom will you serve. Bottom line is, where will you spend eternity? It'll either be heaven or hell. There's no in between. There's no middle ground. You either be with Jesus or separated from Jesus. And we're talking about eternity. This is the most important decision you'll ever make in your life. We pray that you reach out, and take a hold of the unchangeable hand of the great I am. That you get things settled between you and the Lord this very hour, this moment, right now, this day. Remember, today is the day of salvation. Listen, don't put it off. You don't have the promise of the next breath you're to take. You're just a heartbeat away from heaven or hell. Please don't reject Jesus Christ. Surrender. Come on over to the winning side. Amen. We love you guys, and we're praying for you. So come on. Come on over, and you'll understand this agape-type love we've been talking about. You'll understand forgiveness. You'll understand after you accept Jesus, listen, and you receive the Comforter. I'm talking about the promise that comes from Jesus. He said he must go that the Father could send the Comforter. Because, listen, he's not going to leave us comfortless. Come on over to the winning side. Woo! Man, praise God. But now if you reject Jesus, then you're condemned already. God loves you, that he sent his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Reach out, reach up, take a hold of the unchangeable hand of the great I Am, my friend. We want to rejoice with the angels. Come on, let us know. If these radio programs are touching you, if they're helping you and encouraging you to get closer to God, we'd love to hear from you. You can write us. Yep, you can write the old bishop. Just Bishop Eddie Chaney at 219 Red Fox Drive, Crossville, Tennessee. Once again, write this down. Go back. Listen to the archive. You can pause it. Make sure you get the mailing address. You can write us, Bishop Eddie Chaney, 219 Red Fox Drive, Crossville, Tennessee. 38571 is the zip code. Now, if you're riding out of from another country, just put USA at the end of the zip code. We've been receiving letters from Germany and Africa and places, prayer requests, and we mail out a lot of prayer cloths. So, guys, keep those prayers coming. And we do enjoy getting those letters. And we've had a couple be faithful with their letter every Monday. Amen. We're praying over those. We are excited to share that God is moving on those prayer requests as we taught about breaking the spirit of poverty. And we're not talking about money all the time when we talk about the spirit of poverty. And those that listen to those programs and archived, they got aboard that. And there's about seven people that's been participating really good in that. And I'm telling you, I know that God's moving in their lives. It's evident. I've got the letters in hand. We're going to be talking about that, Lord willing, Mondays. Mondays, we're going to be back on that as we share and get everybody up to date with the prayers that have been answered. The letters that they first sent, up to date to the last letters I've received up to date. And you can hear their five major prayer requests and how those changed and how God has met some of their needs and is continuing to meet their needs. He'll meet your need today. If you'll believe and trust him, and if you'll listen, for those that walk upright before God, he will withhold no good thing. He wants to bless you today. He wants you, yes, to be blessed above measure. I'm talking about, look here, you can walk around with a joy that is indescribable. God is good. He will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you just simply don't have enough room to receive, my friend. So choose this day. Amen. Praise God. Give this a listen. We'll be right back.
Hello, Brother Eddie. This is Shirley from Pikeville. I just want to praise the Lord today for... I sat with my brother at the hospital, and he was so blessed today, and people that came to visit, and the Lord just came on him, and he preached such a sermon, and I was so blessed to be there, so blessed to be a part of what God was doing with him today. And he didn't have to wear his machine or the oxygen or anything. The Lord just touched him, and he opened up his lungs. He was like a young child again, and he was so strong, and he didn't get out of breath. God was so good today, and I just want to give him the praise that he deserves for what he does. God can do anything. If you don't know Jesus today, would you kneel down and have a talk with him? And he's waiting with open arms, never listening and waiting for your call. I thank you. I love each and every one of you. And God bless you.
Come, it's getting round. Yeah, the Lord's gonna show the world what he's all about. It's getting closer and drawing near. I've got some things, says the Lord, you wanna hear. It's my love. So come and get a hold of me, and I'll put on my charm. Man, it'll set you free. Just open up your heart and come and get close to me. And in my loving arms is where you'll be. Now you might dance, or you might shout. Oh, the Spirit of the Lord's gonna be poured out. No, there ain't no telling what you might do with my loving arms. Get a hold on you. It's my loving arms, so come and get a hold. Set you free. So open up your heart and come and get close to me. And in my loving arms is where you'll be. It's in my loving arms is where.
God is awesome. Praise God. I tell you, it's a good day to be alive because it is a day that the Lord has made. Let's rejoice and be glad in it. Hey, let me give a big shout out to Sister Carolyn Adams. She says, hello, everyone. I love you. She just got back. She's got some clothes and other things. If anyone needs them, you may want to give her a holler if you're in the Vic Old Kentucky area up there in God's country. Yep, where they pumping the sunshine in. Yeah, you know what I mean. Hey, also, we want to give a big shout-out to Sister Vicki Garrett right there, I think, from Cookeville, Tennessee. Amen, or praise God. We call this the jumping-off place to heaven right here in Tennessee. We surely do, right here up here on the plateau especially. I tell you, we just want to say God bless you, Sister Vicki, and tell Pastor Eddie we just love you guys to death. Miss you guys, man. Hope you can find time to stop by. Also, want to share some good news. Be praying for us. The Lord's willing. We're going to be back on the road again this Saturday, early Saturday morning. We're going to be pulling out, heading back up in through Kentucky, around Kentucky, back down. Woo, may even get a touch Virginia this time. Praise God. We got some people we're going to be seeing. We're going to try to stop by the Tent Revival up there with Brother Philip Williamson and my dad, Corbett Cheney, and Evangelist Willie Grizzle from the House of Prayer Radio. They're going to be in revival, I believe, until the 3rd. So if you're in that area up there in Pikeville, Kentucky, you want to definitely get a hold of Brother Philip Williamson, any of them that can help get you directions in and over in there. Amen. So praise God. And just, well, I think they got one rule. Yep, they're like us. Yep. Can't help it. When you show up, just let go and let God have his way. Amen. Praise God. All right, guys, give this a listen. Okay, Mom got a good report. Amen. Sister Carolyn is sharing. Praise the Lord. She says, Mom got a good report. We've been praying for her family and her brother up there in Ohio, I believe it is, or somewhere. I can't hardly remember. But, man, thank God for all these awesome praise reports that's coming in. We just thank God. Woo! I mean, besides him, friends, there is none other. Amen. All right, give this a listen. We'll be right back.
Come on, this is Brother Boyd London in Idaho. We love you all. We're praying for you, and God bless you. I was going to call in and talk about a true Christian. And I wanted to say a true Christian will live a truly holy life. A true Christian who really loves Jesus will be born again and live a holy life. And I know a lot of people say they believe in Jesus, that they're watching pornography or living with their boyfriends and girlfriends before marriage. A lot of them cuss and curse and use foul language. But if you read Titus 2:11-14, it says the grace of God, Jesus dying on the cross, should motivate us to say no to that sin and to the ungodliness and worldly passions. A true Christian lives a holy life. This Bible right version I got right here, it calls this Rules for Holy Living, Colossians chapter 3. Since you've been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above and not on earthly things, for you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory. Put to death, now it says, put to death, don't do it, put to death, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature, sexual immorality, impurity, lust, the other version calls that fornication, evil desires and greed, which is adultery. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming. You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived, but now you must rid yourself of all such things as these. Anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie to each other, since you've taken off your old self of its practices and have put on the new self. See, that's the thing. You're supposed to be born again. You're supposed to put on the new self. You're a new creation. The things you used to do, you don't do them anymore. The places you used to go, you don't go there anymore. If you went to strip clubs, if you went and did bars and got drunks, you don't do that anymore. You're a new creation. You go out there, and instead of going, well, if you do go to those places, you stand outside of them and you preach the word of God to people and preach Jesus to them and get people saved instead of living in those sins. You know, we are called. We have to go out there and preach to the people that are living in these sins and help them get saved also, but we're not supposed to keep doing them. We've got to be born again, a new creation. So anybody who's a true Christian will be a new creation. I had pornography, anger, cursing, foul language, all that stuff in my life, and was powerless, couldn't get it out of my life. But when I confessed Jesus as Lord, I was baptized in the lake, Jesus came into my heart and life, the Holy Spirit came into my heart and life, and they got those sins out of my life. I wasn't controlled by them anymore. And now I can preach the good news of Jesus to others and help them get the sin out of their life and help them get saved also. But just remember, we have to put those to death. Let's let Jesus put to death the foul language and those horrible sins and get them out of our life. A true Christian is truly born again and truly lets Jesus help them get the sin out of their lives and they don't continue doing those sins. Let's get the sin out of our lives and live righteously. God bless all and have a good day. Jesus loves you.
Amen. I want to say thank you to Brother Boyd and Sister Shirley Collins for calling in and utilizing that testimony line. That just touches my heart. You guys, thank you from the bottom of my heart. I really, really. You'll never know. You know, I tell all my friends, you want to bless me? You want to do something to help me, but you don't have no money? Maybe you can't get to us, and you can pray for us, and you can call that testimony line, and that's one way of showing that agape love, isn't it? If you say you love me, I say just show me. You know, it ain't like I asked, you know, for guys to do things that's above and beyond their capabilities. I asked because I'm trying to fill these airways with the glorious gospel of our precious Lord and Savior. I ask because I want you to be an overcomer. Just pick up the phone and dial 1-931-229-0768. Amen. And remember, that's what we were talking about today, the new project right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox, Project Love. You want to go back, listen to the archive. If you didn't get to hear the program, I'm telling you, we're just, God's directing, we're growing, things are happening. Woo, God's good. And besides him, there is none other, my friend. Amen. So help us out. Pick up the phone and let your light shine. Amen. Be an overcomer. I mean, smack a devil right upside the head. Praise God in the name of Jesus. All right. Also, I see Sister Carolyn reminded me, yeah, we're supposed to be there the 16th with you. There, I believe it is. Am I right? Did you
I think Pauline's got it wrote down. I'm not sure. My helper's in the bed right now. But anyway, we're going to be there the 16th. Amen. The Gospel Music Jukebox. And one good thing about, well, there's many good things about being there in Vico, but one real awesome thing is when we're there by Sister Carolyn's, we've got internet. We can do live broadcast on the Gospel Music Jukebox. So we'll be broadcasting that. Amen. And just come on, stop by. Hey, get in touch with her. She'll give you directions. When you turn in right there at Vico, you know, the next driveway, you'll see the tent right there from the main road. But just turn right and come on in. I don't know which tent. If you guys are going to get a tent, or do you want me to see Chris about his tent and bring it with us, you can let us know. Either way, let us know. We got time till the 16th. Also, remember now, the 16th, mark that on your calendar. If you really want to get up, get out, and do something for Jesus, amen. I mean, do something you ain't never done before. Step out in faith and just let God be God. Deny self. Pick up your cross and follow after Jesus. Watch what happens. Wow, praise God, souls will be won and added into the body of Christ. I'm telling you, the blind will receive sight, deaf will hear, the lame will walk. My goodness, all you got to do is press through traditions of men and press through things of the world and touch but the hem of his garment. My goodness, come on. Everybody's invited. I see she's inviting everybody, and if you can show up, just come on. Show up, let go, and let God have his way. And because I'm telling you, Vico needs, and we're going to be there around Memorial, the 28th, I believe. I can't remember all the dates, but maybe Carolyn can help us. But we're going to be on the main street of Vico, amen, with another preaching and singing. Woo! Look out right there on the main street, the city park. I'm telling you, gets gooder and gooder every day. Hey, that reminds me, also April the 30th, we'll be in Lake City. The Gospel Music Jukebox Sons of Thunder Ministry will be at in Rocky Top, Tennessee. Used to be called Lake City. They changed the name. But Rocky Top, Tennessee, at Brother David Taylor's house, outside service. Amen. If you can, stop by. Get a hold of us. If you, you know, want more information on it, feel free to give me a call at 1-931-248-6730. Give me a call and we'll get you informed where you can, well, just come and worship the Lord thy God in spirit and truth. Amen. Just let go and let God have his way. Praise God. We got a lot of good news, a lot of good things happening. So please keep those prayers coming. We need them. We're going to be at Brother Chester Boston's house praying about another tent revival there. They've informed us that they've got a big tent, access to a big tent with a PA system and things like that. We're going to get down there coming up right here after we come off the road over the weekend. We're going to be down there around Monday or Tuesday, Lord willing, and we're going to be staying all night. Me and the wife's going to shoot down, eat some chili. We're going to get some chili and hugs. Amen. As we go down there and just pray with them and see what date God is going to give for the tent down there in Adair County, I believe it is, or roundabout there anyway, Greensburg, I believe. But we're going to get down in there and just let God have his way with us, just willing vessels showing up and saying, Lord, use us, send us, we'll go. Here I am. Here am I, Lord. Woo, praise God. All right, man, we got a lot of things going on. I'm going to get up with Brother Donnie. Sis and C are on here. Please call me. Okay. All right. So, praise God. Yeah. The Lord's good. It just keeps getting gooder and gooder each and every day. Hold on. If you've got Jesus, hold on, church. Don't let go. Hold on to him. Endure to the end, and the same shall be saved. Give this a listen. We'll be right back.
Hello, everyone. This is Shirley from Michael. My scripture today is Romans 12, 1 and 2. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Thank you all very much, and I love you, and God bless each and every one.
Gate. Peter and John came walking his way. Peter looked down and saw the man was lame. He said, "Get up in Jesus' name." The man jumped up and he started to leap. He felt the power of God from his head to his feet. And that same God is waiting on you and me to get up, get up and praise and get up. Praise and get up. Get up and praise and get up. Get up and praise and problems come. Times get tough, but he's still a God that's more than enough. So get up. Get up and praise and get up. Four lepers at the end of the rope, sick and diseased and all out of hope. One jumped up and began to cry. He said, "Boys, we just can't sit here and die." So they started walking and their legs were weak, but the power of God got into their feet. And that same God is waiting on you and me to get up. Get up and praise and get up. Get up and praise and get up. Get up and praise and get up. Get up. Get up and praise and problems come. Times get tough, but he's still a God that's more than enough. So get up. Get up and praise and get up.
Yes, praise God. And yes, Sister Carolyn, I will let Kevin Opal know. I believe we done did. Matter of fact, when we showed up the other day there, I told him he was already booked. Amen. And you're going to get up with Brother Donnie and them, everybody on here. We want you to know that April the 16th, starting about 3 o'clock over at Sister Carolyn Adams and Brother Jody Adams there with Rocky and Mama. Over there at Vico, if you can, stop by. Going to be a yard tent revival, one night service, I believe, or whatever God wants to do. I mean, it may be, I don't know, you know, just leave it in God's hands. Amen. But we're going to show up. We're going to be there. Going to bring the radio equipment. We're going to broadcast live. So come on out. Come on over. Help us. Going to have a barbecue, I believe. Going to feed you both ways, naturally and spiritually. Praise God. Come on over and just let go and let God have his way. Amen. So God bless each and every one of you. You guys are awesome. If you can, and if you would, please share the program. And let all your friends and family, co-workers, neighbors know that God's not dead. He's alive. and he's working actively in the lives of his people. Praise God. Woo, it's a good day. It is a day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'm telling you, hey, friends, it don't do nothing but get gooder and gooder. Praise God. Besides, I tell you, it's just wonderful to see the people of God on fire for God. Ain't no doubt about it. Just blesses my heart. And also, please remember Sam Vanderburg. I've been wanting to get over there and see him here in Crossville, Tennessee. He's been pretty sick, and we've got this bug. So I've got to wait till I get rid of this cold, this bug, whatever it was, hit my wife, hit me. I was up last night with a headache, so I went ahead and cleaned the computer and worked on it. But I've been having a bad headache this morning, so continue to pray for me. I claim my victory. I claim my healing as I stand upon the word and the promises of our precious Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. But keep those prayers coming, because I want to get out and visit a few people before the weekend, before I leave town again. There's a few things I'm trying to get done, so I need prayer for strength. Woo! I just need continuous prayer. Amen. For Sons of Thunder Ministry, the Gospel Music Jukebox, and this old bishop and my family, if you would please. And we'll continue to pray for you and your family. I pray that God continue to bless you and every member of your family as you continue to be a blessing to others, my friend. Know that we love you, and we'll see you next time right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. Now remember, tonight, if you can, Lord's a willing, you get to if you want to. Yep, that's what we say. Drop in about 7 o'clock p.m. We're going to be trying to finish up the Bible study about who and what is a Christian tonight, 7 p.m. Central Time, right here at the Gospel Music Jukebox. We love you, my friends. Keep on keeping on.
As I hit the highway, humming the tune, I'm on the road again. Another day, another motel room, paying the price to do what I do. But Lord knows I wouldn't trade it for anything. It's not a show, it's not a dream, it's a higher call I'm following. I'll go anywhere, any place the good Lord leads. And when Sunday morning rolls around, I might be on stage in some one-horse town, spreading the good news and shaking everybody's hand. It's just another day of this preacher man. I'm not on the list of the rich and famous, I'm just out here working for Jesus, doing the best I can to reach one more soul. Yeah, I've got a family and God I miss them. They know that I'm kissing goodbye, down the road I go. It's not a show, it's not a dream, it's a higher call I'm following. I'll go anywhere, any place the good Lord leads. And when Sunday morning rolls around, I might be on stage in some one-horse town, spreading the good news and shaking everybody's hand. It's just another day in the life of this preacher man. People say,
Hey, man, haven't I seen you? Don't you sing that song about whiskey? Let me shake your hand. It's just another day in the life of this preacher man.